gun. Numbers 4 and 5 open up the breech, which involves undoing this bottle screw and then lifting out the breech piece. Now the ammunition's been supplied to number 3, who's putting the gunpowder bag into the bore and positioning it. If we were allowed to fire a shell, the shell would have gone in first. But unfortunately, in these days of health and safety, and also we don't want to upset the neighbours, but we're not allowed to fire a shell. So with the powder bag carefully positioned, the breech is closed up. Very important, and that's closed tightly. So once we're loaded, the next range of commands will enable the gun to be laid onto the target. You can see that it's mounted on these racers, so the whole platform can be moved from side to side. And also you've got this hand wheel here to adjust the elevation. So once it's laid onto target, command ready is issued. The number 5 takes one of these, a friction tube, out of his pouch. He inserts it into the breech. In here would be a bar he attaches his lanyard to, and he now stands ready to fire. This tube would contain very fine crystal powder. As he pulls the lanyard, it's a bit like striking a match, which sends a flame down into the charge.
That's a misfire.
That is a misfire, so we'll just try another shoe. So it just takes another shoe. So fingers crossed, ladies and gentlemen. That's a bit better. You can see the amount of smoke that's produced. Sponge! We have to make sure that there's no evidence of the previous round removed from the gun. So number 2 takes a sheepskin sponge and swabs out, removing the
It's a big bang, isn't it? Yeah, they're going to do it one more time. But you know it's coming now, can't you?
It'll blow off.
Do you want to go sit over there? Or do you want to drop me to pick you up? What do you want to do?
So in case you jumped when you took the picture of the firing, we're going to do the whole lot for you again. Hopefully it will fire most of the time. Shrapnel! Fuse 20! No! Now this weapon requires 3 different sorts of ammunition. What's called common shot, which is just a solid shell. It would be fired out, it would land in the field and explode. So you can use that in siege drones. You can also fire something called shrapnel, and that's called a shrapnel shell. That's fitted with a time fuse that's followed by the bursting charge inside. As the time fuse burns away, as the shell's firing out, 20 seconds is what I call for it. You set 20 seconds. 20 seconds after firing, it would explode. So it would be in the air, it would explode, causing a large area to be covered with pieces of shrapnel. That's where it comes from, the shrapnel shell. That would maim anything that was in its way. If things got really desperate, we would fire something called case shot. The case shot, if you imagine a large baked bean tin, 7 inches round, fat and small. Instead of having bullets, it had musket bullets. And it was a bit like a large shotgun, a maximum range of 500 yards. But if the infantry were coming up the hill in force, you'd fire a case shot at them and just wipe them out huge numbers. So the men are reloaded. Just check, yep, it's safe. Once again, steps forward, inserts the friction tube, attaches the lanyard. Stands ready. So, get this
ourselves ready.
Fire! Sponge! Now that charge was fast today. Just a £2 charge. A full charge on this would be £11. And it would be firing a shell. In which case, imagine the amount of smoke would be 5 times as much, and the whole of that gun carriage would recoil up that slope.
What is it?
What is it?